Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jim Sedepin, the director of the Academy. Welcome to our Academy Chamber Music Concert. I just wanted to let you know that, as in the past performances, we do have these sheets along with your programs. We ask each of our student groups to have someone introduce the piece of music that they're playing to help you be able to enjoy it more. At the end of the concert, if you would put either the name of the person or the name of the group who you felt gave the best speech, that would be terrific. Thank you very much. We hope you enjoy the concert.
Hello, we are the Meraki Piano Quartet, and today we are going to be playing a composition by Joaquin Turina. This particular piano quartet takes inspiration from Iberian landscapes and is relatively unknown because most of Turina's works were for orchestral groups and not chamber groups, so this is relatively unique. Turina is also somewhat controversial for his involvement in the Spanish Franco regime as a cultural minister, and for that reason, this piece is also slightly controversial. Regardless, we hope you enjoy it, and as we perform it, we encourage you to look out for the Spanish landscape motif, so the landscape that Turina composed in. This is mainly emerald waters contrasting against rocky mountains and blue skies. Before we begin, we'd all like to thank our coaches, Ms. Felder and Ms. Lee, for helping us to prepare this Iberian masterpiece.
Thank you. Testing. Ooh, okay. Good evening, everyone. My name is Mark Tu. We are the Hermes Piano Trio, and today we are grateful and honored to be playing a piece by a composer who's still with us, Vivian Fung. This is her scherzo. It's fun, it's fast, it's flamboyant, and full of rhythmic energy. Even though it's only 5 minutes long, it's always got this relentless forward momentum. And although it's very easy to hear this in the beginning and the end, it's also there in the lyrical middle section. Throughout the piece, three instruments pass along ideas, interrupt each other, and even finish each other's sentences. But amid this rapid dialogue, there are also moments where we all play in unison. These special moments are the metaphorical exclamation marks for this piece's musical sentences. Full of energy and exuberance, Vivian Fung's scherzo is quite a thrilling ride. We would like to thank our coaches Rodolfo Vieira and Mark George for guiding us through this whirlwind, and please buckle your seatbelts. Please enjoy. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Klangfarben Trio, and tonight we will be playing for you Brahms' Horn Trio in E flat major. This trio was originally intended for piano, violin, and French horn. However, tonight we will be playing a transcription for you with viola instead of French horn. This piece was primarily inspired by two things, the first of them being the Black Forest, which is a dark forested mountain range in southwestern Germany. But more importantly, it was inspired by the death of Brahms' mother. Brahms was very close with his mother, therefore he was greatly impacted by her passing, and he wrote the piece shortly after her death. When listening to the piece, it is very easy to hear how he portrays and incorporates his inspirations. Listening to the piece itself sounds very much like walking through a forested mountain, where certain passages are very slow and broad, and they almost feel like trudging through the muddier parts of the forest, only to get to the summit. Now, these summits or peaks are either very mournful, or they're exclamations of hope. We hope that you will be able to hear these things and that you will be able to enjoy this hike of Brahms's Dark Forest with us. Finally, we would like to thank our wonderful coaches, Paul Zafer and Sangwoo Mo, for their amazing work. Thank you very much, and please enjoy.
Good evening, everyone. We are Duo Spezzatura, and tonight we will be performing Beethoven's First Sonata. This piece starts off with a very bold and energetic opening, followed by a lyrical melody. Throughout the entire piece, you will hear sudden, loud, and soft moments, which is quite common, especially for Beethoven. He dedicated this piece for his teacher at the time, Salieri, who was a famous opera composer. What Clara and I love about this piece is the ongoing conversation that the violin and piano has within the changes in the music. Finally, we'd like to thank our coaches, Debbie Mislowski and Sarah Plum, for their wonderful guidance. We thank you for coming and hope you enjoy our performance. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Ellen Zhao, and tonight I will be playing the Adagio and Fugue from Johann Sebastian Bach's First Sonata for Violin. Interestingly, the set of six sonatas and partitas were not published until almost 100 years after their completion. The Adagio, a slower movement, has an airy, subdued melody that is rhapsodic and scattered with ornamentations. The Fugue, a form of music where several melodies are heard at once, combines a serious character with a more spirited loveliness. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope you enjoy this performance.
evening.
Hello, my name is Amelia, and tonight I'll be performing Tchaikovsky's Variations on a Rococo theme. Tchaikovsky wrote this piece during a depressive point in his life, after his latest opera had, quote, shamefully bungled. However, it's difficult to imagine his dark state of mind because of its light and humorous nature. Tchaikovsky wrote this piece as an homage to Mozart, whom he idolized. Mozart lived during the Rococo period, which is most known for its lavish and elegant architecture, and these qualities can be seen throughout the piece. It starts with the theme, which is light, tasteful, and refined, and sets the stage for the following variations. These variations range from deep and emotional to bright and vibrant, and they seamlessly flow from one to the next. I don't want to spoil the entire piece, so I'm going to leave it at that. This is one of my favorite pieces to perform, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Miroslav Mikhailenko, and I'm joined by Zachary Guo. Tonight, it is our great pleasure to perform the variations on a theme by Paganini, by Witold Lutosławski. To give you a little bit of context, the piece was written in 1941, after Lutosławski, being an officer in the Polish army, successfully escaped his initial capture. In the following years, he formed a piano duo and performed in small cafes and popular nightclubs to make his living. Finally, it's hard to believe, but he actually composed more than 200 compositions during this time. And we're very fortunate to have the score of these variations, because they are the only surviving composition by him from World War II.
All right, so I'm going to have Miroslav play the theme for this piece, which is from Paganini's 24th Caprice for solo violin. Familiar, right? So, this Caprice for violin, Paganini infused virtuosity, flames, wildness. And I like to think of Lutosławski more as a mad chemist instead of a composer in this case, because what he does is he takes this already wild piece and then he injects it with a mutant and it turns into this already wild piece even wilder, and I can't wait for you guys to hear it. Finally, we'd like to thank our coaches, Mr. and Mrs. Naiwim, and I really hope you enjoy.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Claire Zhang, and I'd like to announce a slight change in the program. I will actually be performing Gretchen at the Spinning Wheel by Schubert, transcribed by Liszt. This song was originally composed as a piece for voice and piano by Schubert, but was later transcribed to just piano by Liszt. It was based off the poem Faust by Goethe, and throughout the piece, you'll be able to hear a spinning wheel in the right hand and a heartbeat in the left hand, and I will play those for you now. Here's the spinning wheel. And during the climax of the piece is when Gretchen remembers her first kiss with Faust. And this is when the spinning wheel finally stops. And after hesitating to compose herself, she finally continues spinning the wheel. Thank you for coming, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Stefan Westerberg, and tonight you will hear the theme and variations on Draw the Sacred Circle Closer, written by Adolphus Hailstork. This work is for solo cello, taken from a theme from one of the composer's earlier works, a cantata, which is a work for chorus and orchestra, entitled Earthrise, the vocal parts containing many aspects of Schiller's Ode to Joy, which is also famously used in the last movement of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. The cantata was commissioned by the Cincinnati Symphony in the mid-2000s in lieu of riots responding to cases of police brutality and racial profiling in the city. The cantata is meant, then, to inspire a sense of closure in peace and love, responding to a situation from which much hate and chaos was founded. There is a particularly spiritual theme upon which the cello theme is based, and this undergoes many transformations and counteracting characters, ultimately resulting in a triumphant conclusion. As you listen to this piece, I hope that it inspires a sense of reflection within you of which you can take part, contemplating the current state of our world and what it means to live in a truly liberated society. Thank you.
All right, great.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Mingxi, and we are the Alora String Quartet. Tonight, we'll be playing the first movement of Carl Nielsen's First String Quartet. Composed in 1888, this quartet actually wasn't publicly performed until 10 years later, probably because it is filled with sounds that were considered new and unusual. Fortunately for us, listeners now are much more accepting of unexpected harmonies and the blending of melodic and percussive lines. This movement keeps a wonderful balance between all of those elements. Hopefully, if we do our job right, you will hear harmonies that surprise you in the most beautiful way and melodies that touch you with their gentleness. According to classicalmusic.com, and I quote, Nielsen, like Sibelius, was an average violinist, distinctly average, it would seem, end quote. And while we don't know much about his violin playing, we can tell from our study of the string quartet that his composing is quite above average. Before we perform, we would like to thank our coach, Claudia Lazarev Mironov, for all of her support and chamber music wisdom. We hope you enjoy listening to this movement as much as we have enjoyed rehearsing it. Thank you.
Testing. Hello, my name is Jan Vargas Nedvecki, and this is the Omaggio String Quartet. And tonight we'll be performing the first movement of Beethoven's Harp String Quartet. The nickname for this quartet refers to the lively and vivacious pizzicato sections, which are reminiscent of the plucking of a harp, as we can preview for you here. As you can see, it almost seems as if a layer of sounds created by multiple instruments can sound like one single instrument. Beethoven wrote this string quartet in 1809, which was a turbulent year for him because he was forced into hiding by the French Empire, who occupied Vienna at the time. Despite the tempestuous times, Beethoven was still able to complete this quartet. This piece begins with a pensive, thought-provoking, lyrical section, which builds upon itself in an increasing tension that eventually bursts into a joyous and extremely light-hearted character, which is retained throughout the remainder of the piece. We would like to thank our wonderful coach, Matthias Take, for his dedication and support. Without any further ado, we present to you Beethoven's Harp Quartet. We hope you enjoy.
We are the Hyacinth Quartet, and tonight we will be playing the third movement of Bacovich's Fourth String Quartet. Regina Bacovich was a Polish composer who lived throughout the 20th century. Besides being an accomplished violin soloist, she was also a prolific composer, especially of chamber music. The movement that we'll be playing is a dramatic rondo, which is a musical form where a theme returns. This rhythmic, dance-like movement is in a neoclassical style, which is why you might hear the harmonies of Stravinsky, but also the elegance of Haydn. The character in this movement seems to change every few bars, from a lighthearted dance in the sunshine to a melancholy walk in the rain, and then from a spirited voyage at sea to a disoriented journey through a storm. We hope that you find this suspenseful and exciting work as remarkable as we do. We'd like to thank our wonderful coach Rodolfo Vieira, and thank all of you for coming, and please enjoy Bacovich's Fourth String Quartet. Thank you.